Hey everyone, Ryan from Earth Trim Gardens. Very excited today and a little bit sad because this might be the last visit of this property. It's been a journey, but we're basically almost there. So all that I've got left is that section back there, which is 50% raised veggie beds, patch garden beds, so to speak. And a lawn that is like predominantly weeds, so it's really long and thick and wet. So I'm going to run it down with the whipper snipper first and then see what it looks like. I will hand pull the weeds, and that corner just over there is a garden bed that I'll weed as well. Then basically it's just a matter of clearing up the wooden debris that was still over there last time, giving everything a blow, and then actually no, there'll be one more visit, my mistake. I'll come back and pressure wash all the paving and pathing and so on. But as far as the gardening goes, yeah, this should be it. Really happy to hear that you enjoyed this new intro format, basically. So I'll roll with that moving forward. Hope you enjoy this one and speak to you soon. So I'm 15 minutes in and I've already decided that this will no longer be the last visit as far as gardening goes. So the good news is there's another video to come. The reason being is I want to actually make sure that these raised beds or veggie patches are actually usable moving forward. There's a heap of kikuyu growing through there and I don't want to just leave it like that, and I definitely don't want to poison it. So I'm going to rip it all out. So it'll be a bit more time consuming, but I'd rather get it done right. I don't own a rotary hoe, so I'm going to have to get in there and dig. But yeah, a little bit more time consuming, but a better end result. Let's keep going. So, yes, that is a lot of hard work, extremely labour intensive, but I think the results speak for themselves. I'd much rather leave a job with the garden bed looking like this than what it was going to look like in the first place. So I will just continue working my way around this bed with the whippersnipper now until I hit the next garden bed, and we'll keep going. I believe there's three of them here. There's one where that electric fence is, and there's another one just behind this one here. I believe up in the back corner there is nothing as far as garden beds go. The only instructions from the client was to please leave the rhubarb, which of course I will do. All right, let's keep on going.
Yeah.
really hard work, a lot of intense labor there, but it's really starting to turn out quite nicely. These garden beds look great and ready for use. Couple of things you might wonder why I stopped there and just didn't keep on whip snipping. Reason is I felt like I'd worn enough fertilizer for the day. Hidden gems everywhere in there, and I'm covered, as wonderful as it is to hear. So I'll come back and do that next time around. And the other thing I just wanted to let you all know, a few of you did have concerns in previous videos about my back. Now, while I do really appreciate those concerns, there's nothing for you to worry about. I actually just recently purchased a back brace, which I wear for more labor intensive work. It's very thin, but it does a great job, hardly noticeable, and I was actually wearing it for the times that I was digging these veggie patches. All right, everyone, I hope you enjoyed, and I will speak to you next time. Thanks for watching.